Well, you know, I woke up this morning and, you know, my phone, at some point this morning, started blowing up, and you know, friends and acquaintances and fans that I've known from over the years, you know, started tweeting me. And then a woman who works with us in the within the company we've been working on, Diana Ritchie, our HR director, called me and was the first to really break to me, you know, the seriousness of it. And once I was able to get online later in the morning and started following along and seeing that, you know, that this really was something, that, you know, there really was something going on. You know, everybody knows, it's any wrestling fan knows the differences that he and I've had, professional differences. But, you know, but my mom used to say, with age comes wisdom. You don't get to be 52 without living it. You know, and so for me, you know, as that young kid that really felt put upon by Ric Flair and spewed a lot of that venom, a lot of that anger still resides inside me. That's professional difference. But on a personal level, I don't wish bad on anybody. It has nothing to do with religion, because you guys know I'm agnostic. I just have seen enough people in my business die that I don't sit back and hope, boy, I wish this one or that one does, but not the other guys. I don't want to see any of these guys die. And, you know, when you hear somebody as iconic and as impactful on the industry that I made my professional life in as Ric Flair, you know, that is one of the giants. And so I wrestled for part of the morning and into the afternoon with, do I post some personal comment? And invariably I came back to, if I did, as we know, there's some people out there that find sport in trolling. I didn't want to provide any fodder for that and take the eye away from, you know, Rick's recovery. And so I thought it best just to retweet a picture that I had seen recurring over and over on social media, and, you know, hopefully that'll bear its way through. But I wish him the best of luck in his recovery. And you know, like I said, I'm agnostic, so I'm not a prayerful guy, but I really do hope that Rick makes a full recovery and can enjoy his life for decades to come. It'd be a huge loss to the wrestling industry and those of us that have made our livings in this industry to lose somebody like Ric Flair. So, with that said, all as much positive thought and energies I can send out there for Rick goes out. My personal differences, my professional differences aside with him, still look to him even through all of that. I looked up to Ric Flair as a measuring stick in the business, and so I wish him all the best in recovery.